seeds that were planted there. When I show you the blossoms and point out the vines, you don't see them. You're looking so hard for the flower when the hour is still ahead. And all that is not showing is growing. And that is why
I'm believing for the best in you. Believing for the best in you.
You've got Jesus in your heart
and you love him so.
As Stormie was saying earlier, that we both were really products of God's restorative work. I ended up in a mental institution in 1965, and yet I didn't feel like any of that had to do with an oppressive childhood. I thought, in fact, I learned that it all had to do with pride. And I'm sure a lot of you question, well, pride, how can pride have symptoms like anxiety and fear and feelings of worthlessness? But you see, I really found out a long time ago that pride exalts itself. And I found that as long as I wanted to do things my way, and as long as my ego had to be up there above God, I was going to be unsuccessful in life. And I did well. I mean, I was successful, but I was a miserable person. And it all came to a head when I ended up in the institution. When I got out, I spent about 12 to 15 years with extreme depressions, fear, anxiety, and paranoia. After that many years, it was still with me. I had known the Lord for almost that entire time, but I insisted on my own way. I insisted on having things in an order that I would say that I was responsible for. And I remember in 1979, I finally went and sought the Lord's counsel, and it really came down to God wanting to show me Him. He wanted to have me adopt the mind of Christ, not my own mind. And I remember distinctly that God told me that I was supposed to spend the next however long it took in my prayer closet every day praising Him, not asking Him for things, not saying, Lord, I've been miserable for 15 years. Will you please take this away? He said, I want you to praise my name. He said, I want you to exalt me. He said, I will give you the mind of Christ. And so every day for about a year, I went into my closet and I praised God. And I emerged a very different person. And it really had so little to do with me trying to produce something. It really had to do with praising God and Him filling my life with Him. And it was beautiful because after that total deliverance happened, I have not experienced anything like that again. And I praise God for that. And I say that as an encouragement to you to realize that pride sets itself against God. And pride goeth before a fall. And I had fallen radically. And God wants to fill every one of our lives with Him, the mind of Christ. And that mind is in perfect communion with the Father. I tell you, I never thought I'd be free of this in my whole life. I'd never expected it. I expected it was something I'd have to live with for the rest of my life. But God really delivered that from me. And now I can walk really free of that stuff that really had me down. And so we wrote a little song here. And it deals with Jesus, the restorer, the healer. It's called Dr. Jesus.